and welcome to my YouTube channel Biological Domain. Today we will learn about types of connective tissue. In last video we have discussed connective tissue introduction. So let's start with the types of connective tissue. Connective tissue is majorly divided into two, that is connective tissue proper and specialized connective tissue. Okay, so connective tissue proper is further divided into loose connective tissue and dense connective tissue. And specialized connective tissue is divided into skeletal and fluid connective tissue. So, let's start with the loose connective tissue. What is the meaning of loose? Loose means fiber are less and matrix are more. Matrix are more and fibers are less. And it is further divided into areolar and adipose connective tissue. This is the structure of areolar loose connective tissue and this is the structure of adipose loose connective tissue. What is the function of areolar loose connective tissue? It work as a packaging tissue, means it packages anything to the tissue. Means it connects skin to muscle and it is present beneath the skin. And this is the structure in which fibroblasts are present. Fibroblasts secrete collagen fiber. This is mast cell and there are macrophages, that is cell present here. And there in spaces there are matrix present. This is matrix. This is all about the areolar loose connective tissue. Adipose loose connective tissue. This is the structure of adipose loose connective tissue where this is nucleus are present and this is fat storage area which is also known as adipocyte. And function of adipose loose connective tissue is to protect body from mechanical shock. It acts as an insulating layer and the cell of this tissue is specialized to store fat. That's why fat people don't feel cold and thin people feel cold because of this adipose loose connective tissue. In fat people, adipose connective tissue are present more, but in thin people, adipose connective tissue are present in less in number. This is all about the connective tissue proper, loose connective tissue. And next one is dense connective tissue. Dense means there fibers would be more and matrix would be less, opposite to the loose connective tissue. So divided into dense regular and dense irregular. What the meaning of dense regular? These are cells. And this is fibers. So fibers and lace both are present in a regular manner. In dense regular, fiber and cells are present in regular manner. But in dense irregular, fiber and cells are present in irregular manner. Fibers are parallel to cell and here fibers are not parallel to cell. If we talk about the dense regular types, it is divided into tendon and ligament. What is tendon? Tendon is a joint which connects muscle to bone. And ligament is a joint which connects bone to bone. We can remember this by trick like BBL, bone to bone ligament, and MBT, muscle to bone tendon. Sometimes we found a sprain. What is the sprain? A sprain is excessive pulling of ligament. In Hindi, we call mooch. So we found mooch in why? Due to excessive pulling of ligament. Means excessive pulling of bone to bone connection. Where bone has joined from bone. There, if it is excessive pulling, then we feel mooch. And next, specialized connective tissue. This is divided into skeletal and fluid. Skeletal specialized connective tissue is divided into bone and cartilage, and fluid specialized connective tissue is divided into blood and lymph. In fluid, this is fiberless matrix. This is fiberless. Fiber are absent there. Fluid are fiberless matrix. Okay. So let's discuss one by one. That is, supportive or skeletal connective tissue is further divided into bone and cartilage. We know there are 206 bone present in human adult, and they are distributed throughout the body. So this is the structure of bone. If we see, the outer layer is known as periosteum, inner layer is known as endosteum, and the red color structure, this is known as red bone marrow, where RBC are formed. And this is yellow bone marrow. This bone marrow used during emergency, when extra bleeding happens during emergency, this yellow bone marrow acts like a red bone marrow, and it also forms RBC. As we have seen, in femur bone, which is longest bone of the body, there is a hollow space in which there is some liquid substances are present. There bone marrow formed. So this is RBC and yellow bone marrow. If we cut the section of this bone from here, this section, if we cut, then if we see in a diversity lens, then it would look like this. This is periosteum layer. After that, there are osteoblasts. Osteoblast means cells which are present in bones. This is osteoblast. And these are Habercian canals are present, which forms a ring-like structure behind that, and which join two Habercius canal, that is known as Wachmann's canal. And this portion is known as endosteum, and where bone marrow form below it. Okay, this all about the bone. If we dissect bone in comparative manner, and bone is rigid, hard, and the growth is bidirectional. Bidirectional means bone can grow from this side also, and bone can grow from this side also. Bone can grow from both the side. This is bidirectional. But if we talk about the cartilage, it is flexible and it is soft. It present in ear pinna or upper part of ear, tip of nose, trachea, etc. If we see the figure of cartilage, this looks like that, in which the upper part is known as perichondrium. Here in bone, periosteum. Osteum means, osteum words related to bone, whereas chondrium words related to cartilage. In cartilage, chondrin protein are present. Chondrin protein are present. After the layer of perichondrium, there are chondroblasts, which is known as mother cell. Mother cell for cartilage. And these chondroblasts forms chondrocytes. After division, these chondroblasts form chondrocytes. And you can see, this is a chondrocytes formed inside a circle, in which there is some matrix are present, which is known as lacuna. And outer side matrix is matrix. If we talk about the growth of cartilage, it is unidirectional. Means cartilage can grow only in one direction. And another one is fluid connective tissue, which is fiberless matrix, means there no fibers are present. It is divided into blood and lymph. In blood we see RBC, WBC and platelets are present. RBC, WBC and platelets. RBC means red blood cells, WBC white blood cells and platelets thrombocytes. All are present in blood. This is all about the connective tissue and how it is differentiated into different types with their diagram and example. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please share with your friends. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.